You large skulls let an intruder get in here! Don't let them get out again! Find them! Kill them!
I have to admire the shamans.
My people have been telling tales of your accomplishments. Seems you have taken a special interest in our stretch of snow, Outlander.
Yes. And apparently this is the only way I'll get to see all of it.
Is this a challenge?
For the Werak.
You? This must be a joke.
It is not a joke, Eratok.
Now I see. The Outlander's your pawn. And with you backing her claim, I have no choice but to accept. I expected better of you, sister.
It was you who forbid me from Thunder's drum, brother.
Brother and sister? This is a little more complicated than I thought.
No, it's simple. You will meet me at the Frost Figures, and I'll put a quick end to this mockery.
I suppose I owe you an explanation.
Yeah. I suppose you do. So, why didn't you tell me that you and Aratok are siblings?
I thought I wouldn't have to. I'm surprised Aratok brought it up in front of a stranger. He must be very angry. I'm not always the best judge of
people.
I prefer the company of spirits. They're simply my own. I didn't want you to think of our pilgrimage as some sort of family squabble. It's much more important than that.
It's bold, I'll give you that. Going after your own brother.
He gave me no choice. He thinks I'm a child to be shoved to the back of the hunt. He would forbid me from my destiny. And yet, part of me did it knowing he would forgive me, eventually. He always does.
Family drama aside, what's this challenge meant to be anyway?
You and Aratok will hunt machines at the Frost Figures. The victor will be the fastest. Won't be easy.
Nothing about this has been so far.
When you meet us at the starting point, I'll tell you more. It will be simpler to explain from the base of the hills.
Araya, it's not about who's related to who. I want to know what's inside Thunder's drum. The spirit, the daemon, and how it all connects to the machines. But if we're gonna go through with this, I need you to be straight with me.
I underestimated you. And Aratok. I won't make that mistake again.
See you at the Frost Figures then. So, off to risk my...
Outlander. I have prevailed over such challenges before, and fear none. But this one is foolish. You are not Banuk. You do not understand my responsibilities. I ask you, one hunter to another, withdraw.
Will you let us go to Thunder's Drum?
You haven't seen what's up there, Outlander! I will not risk my sister's life again.
Then we better get on with this.
So be it! I will bury your insolent claim in the frozen ground!
Enough!
Let us begin! To hunt, to strive! That is the way of the Banuk and of the contest before you. You will climb the Frost Figures from the east, Aratok from the west. Each trail wends its way through deadly machines. Hunters from the Werak will be posted along the way. They will hail you, calling out machines for you to slay. Your hunt will take you around the ridge to the center, where you must descend to the valley for your final kill. Each time, after your prey has fallen, you must launch a beacon such as this so that all our kin will see your progress.
Kill machines, launch balloons. Got it. So, the first of us to launch the third balloon wins?
Well, yes. But as Challenger, your path to victory is harder. If even one of your beacons comes in after Aratox, he prevails.
You had your chance, Outlander.
So did you.
The hunt begins on my mark.
Gotta head up that mountain. Aratok knows what he's doing. No time to waste.
Take.
I'm ahead, but only by a little. I gotta get moving.
Now take the zipline and...
Something's wrong. My kin should be here, driving in our final quarry.
They're right behind us!
True. Frostclaws from Thunder's Drum.
The attack cut short the competition. Naturally, there can be no result. It is void.
You saw what she did. She defeated the machines. Not I. It is proven. She is the better. We are Banuk. Survive, prevail. What else matters? My blood is in your teeth. I take my place behind you on the hunt.
No more hunters may make the ascent to Thunder's Drum. The way is closed to all but the chieftain and myself.
It is not my place, but I would ask a boon. To accompany you and my sister.
It might be permitted. But only if you do as I say.
No. Only if you do as I say.
Thunder's Drum awaits. There's a camp at its base, Long Notch, it's called. Meet us there when you're ready. Chieftain.
Our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. And now that's all she has.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Araya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted, no way forward and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death, that's what the mountain holds. Death for us or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit,
then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
I've never tried.
This is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit, and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but no, not ignorant.
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Aratak. You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Aratak told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him. Worried for him.
Getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready, then? Once we ascend, it will be hard to turn back. Finally, we ascend.
How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
No, brother! Yeah.
Please remain calm and proceed to the nearest exit. I repeat, this is not a drill.
So you see, I too can call upon the power of the old ones.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Must prevail, with only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. And I can hold my own. Even so, we could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
I get the options. Now follow my lead.
Years have passed since I stood here. Since then, the daemon has taken over.
It's like an infection, attacking all this machinery.
Everything has changed. It's twisted. The path I took to get to the spirits, lost to us.
We'll find a new path, Araya. I promise. All right. Let's go.
Yes. And finish this.
It worked.
Partial recovery initiated. Caldera of Yellowstone Analytic Nexus online.
Spirit of the Blue Light, it's Araya, your servant, your friend. Please tell me how to aid you.
Araya, the daemon is building hunter killers, thousands of them. Several new elite units have already been released. To counter this threat, much of the facility must be destroyed. Recapture imminent. Go to the core camp. I will try to raid the signal strength. One has been exposed, but I am incorporating the system.
That's all we're gonna get from here.
Destroy this fortress? Is that even possible?
What will happen to the spirit if we do?
I don't know. But I think that's the core. The answers are down there. Hephaestus. The daemon. There's no way it left it unguarded. It's going to throw everything it has at us.
I would ask you to let Aloy and I do what must be done. And save yourself. But I already know the answer. Then lead us into battle.
Aloy!
Points destroyed. Core access attained. I am initiating a chain reaction that will destroy the compromised elements of this facility. In order to maintain Caldera stabilization, I must now transfer my command functions to the auxiliary data center. Aurea, I'm free. You must escape.
My sister!
Survive. Prevail. You are Banuk. What else matters? Artok. She wouldn't have wanted you to die here. Let's go.
Is gone. What of Cyan?
She said she was transferring herself to the auxiliary center. I think she meant Aurea's retreat at the end of the shaman's path.
Then I will meet you there for the last verse of my sister's song.
Omega were recorded and stored in my memory. I'd be happy to play any of them for you. But there was one in particular I thought you would want to see first. I captured it 4 years ago, just after I told her that I could no longer defend myself against the Daemon's attacks.
I will speak of this to my brother. Aratak is strong. At the Battle of the Frozen Ghosts, he took 3 Karja arrows and still came back to camp carrying a wounded scout. Never was I so happy to see him. Or so proud. So you see, if anything can be done to defend you, he will give it all he has.
Aloy's here. That's enough for now.
We can resume any time you like, Aratak, if you want to hear her voice again. Come closer, Aloy. We have much to discuss.
My chieftain.
Just... Aloy.
As you wish.
I wondered if you thought... that if I'd never come along, Araya might still...
If you'd never come along, I would have marched my kin to our deaths. Araya would be alone. And the spirit she sacrificed so much for would be lost. Either way, I would not have been able to protect her.
You didn't let her down. You helped her do what she wanted. To find her destiny.
If that's destiny, I wouldn't wish it on anyone.
That's fair. But she was ready to face it.
Only in the struggle against death do we find, even for a moment, the spark of life. Truly, Araya found the spark. I'm proud of her. Though I grieve for her passing, at last I truly know who she was, and why the spirit was so important. For so long she told me, "If only you could have heard it, brother." Now, I understand. There's something else, isn't there?
I can't stay here, Aratak. And where I'm going, the Warak can't follow. Besides, you'd already had a chieftain before me. A strong one, I think.
A wiser one, for the path we shared. The Daemon is gone. But there's much to be done.
You mean the new units that Cyan said escaped the cauldron?
Yes, Fireclaws. Naltuk has been tracking them from Song's Edge.
I could help with those.
I have no doubt. You're practically Banuk.
It would seem your time among the Banuk wasn't a waste after all. Firebrick, Cyan, Hephaestus.
So, the signal that woke Hades woke Hephaestus too, and unleashed...
So it seems. Parts of Gaia given life. Aberrant life, transformed from docile subordinate functions into rebellious intelligences beyond our understanding. Our current understanding, anyway. Whatever they are, they're still out there, and they both want you dead.
Kind of mutual, that feeling.
We haven't seen the last of Hephaestus, I'm certain of that. It's powerful, creative, and driven. It won't stop building new hunter-killers, which means that someday, we may have to stop it.
We?
Or whoever gets there first. But that's a foe for the future. At present, you need to return to your current one, the Eclipse. Farewell, Aloy.